Now I'm going to go into assessment and diagnostics. Early assessment may be difficult with Vietnamese because we tend to seek intervention only when there are pressing problems. You'll find your opportunity to diagnose dementia and intervene usually occurs in medical settings in conjunction with treating other ailments such as diabetes, fractures, or the vascular diseases. But whether the assessment is being made in the hospital, clinic, or community center setting, you'll get the best information through a multidisciplinary effort. I really suggest you rely on the collateral reports of your social workers, psychologists, even your physical therapists, and like who have worked with your client in the past to get an accurate picture of what is going on. And this will be especially the case if you're trying to parse out whether your care recipient is depressed, which for many dementias is a precursor, or your patient and client may be delirious or demented. And perhaps even with delirium compounded by a pre-existing dementia. During your assessment, it's also helpful to find out what the family or caregiver has tried in the past to treat the dementia symptom. Things to watch for to aid in future treatment planning and in order to be able to communicate in a culturally syntonic way is to not be afraid to ask about the use of herbs, shamans, and homeopathic remedies, in addition to what kind of Western-based treatments may have been used, the significance of which Dr. Hinton just went over. At worst, the more acculturated of your patients and families will acknowledge your sensitivity and willingness to explore all the possibilities. Beside the brain scan results and other sophisticated test results that you may have available to you, I find using the Montreal Cognitive Assessment or some variation of it with Vietnamese clients and patients to be very easy and helpful. I have here the translated version, which I included as a resource at the end of the presentation. For one thing, the MoCA is great in helping to ferret out dementia of the teacup variety. It's been translated into many different languages, and you can easily adjust it for different levels of culturation and assimilation. With the older Vietnamese patients, you'll find that word recall and serial subtractions are very effective assessment tools, because that generation, even the educated ones, are used to learning by rote memory, and it is a useful piece of information if they are unable to do recall and subtractions. Another very useful tool that can be gleaned from the MoCA is the clock drawing. The clock is a universally recognized symbol, making it an easy, non-threatening way to help determine how severe your non-English speaking Vietnamese patient or client's deficits may be. And for those of you who may not be familiar with the use of clock drawings, here's a clock drawing of an individual with a relatively healthy brain. Whereas on your right, you have a diseased brain whose deficits are reflected by the individual's inability to judge space, plan accordingly, or put in the basic elements. I routinely use the clock drawing because it quickly gives me an indication of possible cognitive changes, and then I request further backup from the doctors and psychologists. Also, in terms of working with families, having the ability to show the caregiver and family the clock drawing to explain the nature of the elder's symptoms gives them something tangible to think about and helps make their understanding of dementia more concrete.
Could I just add one thing on that last slide, Jane? That Sue Borson, who's at the University of Washington, actually has incorporated the clock drawing into a screening test that is called the mini-cog. And she's demonstrated that in ethnically diverse and also in linguistically diverse populations that this has a high sensitivity and specificity for identifying people who have dementia and only takes less than 5 minutes to administer.
Yes, thank you. Now, so back to the slide here. With the more acculturated individuals, other tools that can give you clues regarding impairment is the check writing assessment, which can easily be done in Vietnamese and read by your interpreter. Present your patient or client with a blank piece of paper with a check form on it and ask him to make it out to himself for a specific dollar amount. Another simple exercise is to ask the client to perform a common household activity that they may be expected to do on a daily basis, such as using a toaster or a remote control. I work with a wonderful geriatric clinical nurse specialist who will present her patient with a toaster, ask them to go through the motions of making toast and then stand back to watch whether the patient is able to go through the motions of plugging the thing in, putting the toast in the slot as opposed to on top, etc., and pressing the appropriate buttons. If the patient you're working with is unable to participate in the MOCA, do the clock drawing, or other things physically, beside using the basic questions that indicate awareness of time, place, person, and situation, you can also ask very deceptively simple questions that the elder can easily respond to by nodding or shaking their head or what have you. The one I like to use with intensive care unit patients who are without family or friends and I'm assessing for possible conservatorship is the question, is 1 pound more than 2 pounds? Or with Vietnamese, the more culturally appropriate unit of measure would be the kilogram. And those who are severely demented enough and lacking capacity will most likely not be able to answer that question or give you a very blank stare. If your patient or client is physically able and willing to do neuropsychological testing to help you determine the presence or severity of executive functioning deficits, then that would be wonderful. However, among the Vietnamese population, the most obvious problem would be that it's difficult unless you're a fluent Vietnamese speaker, because accurate translation of the tests is very difficult. Further, using an interpreter may be too time-intensive or financially prohibitive in the regular clinic setting and for most community agencies. Also, beyond their baccalaureate years, taking tests is not a cultural norm for most Vietnamese elders, and you'll find the prospect will be highly anxiety-provoking to both your patient and possibly their family as well, due to the perceived need to, quote-unquote, do well and save face. In addition, the Vietnamese are considered a very high-context culture in that while testing is a great way to get information, you may never even have the opportunity to conduct the test if you aren't able to communicate within the cultural context. And if you're able to do that, you'll find that most of the information you need to make an accurate diagnosis of dementia can be provided to you by talking to the patient and her family or the caregivers. As you probably gathered, the assessment and diagnosis section is focused a lot on communication and being able to get information.